Hi guys, today I'm going to talk about metabolic diversity, specifically photo versus chemo, litho versus organo, and auto versus heterotrophy. So let's get started. I find it easiest to start with photo versus chemotrophy before we get into the rest. So photo versus chemotrophy is pretty simple to remember because photo, light, and phototrophy is just getting your energy from light. So it's all about energy source. When organisms get energy from light, they are phototrophs, and when they get their energy from chemicals, then they're chemotrophs. Also, I put an example up here of this where you see plants getting energy from sunlight, and we humans, as chemotrophs, get our energy from the organic compounds within the plants that we eat, or within the animals that we eat that are eating the plants. So phototrophy is a big deal for us, things that can't just get energy from light. But this depiction, although helpful, does not mean that phototrophy necessarily evolved before chemotrophy. But we won't get into that until later videos. So let's move on to auto versus heterotrophy. Autotrophy and heterotrophy just have to do with the carbon source. So we're all made of carbon. Plants are all made of carbon. Pretty much all living things are built by carbon. There are obviously some other really important elements that go into biological molecules, but the building blocks are all pretty much carbon. And so wherever we get our carbon source can be either an inorganic source or an organic source. So inorganic sources of carbon would be like CO2. And things like plants are example of autotrophs. They get their carbon source from inorganic CO2. And we are examples of heterotrophs. We get our carbon from organic compounds from, for example, like I said, the things we eat. So an organic carbon source is heterotrophy and an inorganic is autotrophy. But before we move on to litho and organotrophy, I just want to mention that organic carbon isn't only CO2. For example, there are microbes that can use methane or CO2 as their carbon source. And I'm sure I'm missing some other inorganic carbon sources, but basically plants aren't the only thing that can use inorganic carbon as their carbon source. So plants aren't the only examples of autotrophs out there. So now we'll move on to litho and organotrophy. Litho versus organo just has to do with the electron donor. So if you're not familiar with metabolism and how electron transport chains and all that stuff work, that's okay. Just know that typically in metabolism, there's an electron donor and electron acceptor to go through the metabolic process and make our energy that we use to live. So examples of inorganic electron donors, which would be lithotrophy, are things like hydrogen, ferrous iron, reduced sulfur, nitrite, ammonia, and there are plenty more. And examples of organic electron donors would be like glucose or glucose derivatives or anything that we get from other organisms that we can then convert in our body to make electron donors out of. And basically, this is just another example of whether organisms are able to use an inorganic substance or organic substance. And so lithotrophy, inorganic, organotrophy, organic. Again, the names there pretty much help. Now let's try and combine some and see what kinds of organisms we can make. First, let's start with the phototrophs. So we can combine photo with auto and organo and get photo-auto-organotrophs or photo-organo-autotrophs, however you want to say it. And if we think about what this means, it would be a light energy source for photo, an inorganic carbon source for auto, and an organic electron donor for organo. Next, we can change the auto to hetero and be photo-hetero-organotroph. And this would mean a light energy source, an organic carbon source, and an organic electron donor. We can also change organo to litho and make it a light energy source, an organic carbon source, and an inorganic electron donor. And lastly, for phototrophs, we can make it auto-litho. So we can have a light energy source, an inorganic carbon source, and an inorganic electron source. Next, we'll move on to chemotrophy. We can have chemo auto organotrophs or chemical energy source, an inorganic carbon source, an organic electron donor. We can also have chemo hetero organotrophs or a chemical energy source, organic carbon source, an organic electron donor. We can also have chemo hetero lithotrophy, a chemical energy source, organic carbon source, an inorganic electron donor. And lastly, we can have chemo auto lithotrophs with chemical energy, inorganic carbon source, and inorganic electron donor. Now, last thing I want to show you is I made you this hopefully helpful table where I put all the different types of phototrophy and chemotrophy respectively with all the different types of auto versus hetero and litho versus organotrophy along with those. And I put what kinds of energy source, carbon source, and electron donor they're using in each case. So if you want to use this table, you could just pause the screen and look at it for as long as you'd like if you need to use it for reference. But also I want to stress a couple things before I let y'all go. First, phototrophy typically goes along with autotrophy. If we're talking about phototrophs, meaning get their energy source from light, we typically see that these organisms are going to be also autotrophs, meaning they get their carbon from inorganic sources like carbon dioxide. However, that doesn't mean that photoheterotrophs can't happen. They typically happen, but they're not things like plants, maybe some sort of specialized microbe or something. Another general rule is that auto and litho typically go together and hetero and organo typically go together, meaning that if you're going to use an inorganic source for your carbon, then you might also typically be using an inorganic source for your electron donor. And similarly, if you're using an organic carbon source, you're typically going to be using an organic electron donor. But again, this is not a rule that's set in stone. It's just a general trend. So that is all I have for you guys. I hope this helped you out, and I hope that you continue to come watch the GeoBio episodes, and I can't wait to see you there. Bye.